So here we go. We got your opening match tonight. That's not me talking, that's her. We're having some audio issues with the arena as usual. Our apologies, but I'll try to fill you in with what I can. In our opening match here, is we have El Diablo facing off with Shawmownage in a last man standing match for the hardcore title. El Diablo believes he's got what it takes to take on this beast known as Shawmownage. Mission in this match, kind of like boxing, where you count to 10. Keep the person down. Not like boxing, because nothing's illegal. Any weapons, anything, so. Don't worry, at Knockout Wrestling, we let the action happen in the ring and stuff, so won't hear me yelling in your ear and everything. Now, Diablo here looks as focused. Now, one of the things that we pointed out, if you're looking at the logo on that shirt, one of the members of Havok has that same kind of design on a shirt that he wears, so could El Diablo be trying to get some gold to make himself more worthy of trying to get into Havok? Is that what he's trying to do? Now we got your hardcore champion, Shawmownage. It's just been steamrolling competition. He has a finishing move where, man, that science goes off the top and does a splash. And nobody survived that so far. So we welcome you to Knockout Wrestling. We try to change it up a bit for you, give you something different. We thank you all for coming out. Like I said, we kind of borrowed the Hardcore Championship. Thought we'd bring it back. They weren't using it. El Diablo, your contender. Just anything goes. Oh, little cracks a smile for the crowd for once. And we have the beast known as Shawmownage. Likes his belt, man. When he first came in, we didn't know what he'd be like for wrestling and stuff. He was just beating the crap out of everybody, but once he got that title in his hand, he's been pretty partial to it. El Diablo, Shawmownage, for the hardcore title. Last man standing, it's on. Nice reversal there by El Diablo. Not too sure what's going on there. I think he's just trying to keep him on the ground for now. He's shot in the face. What are you talking, El Diablo? And he said his just plans were just to bring it against Shawmownage, so. Shawmownage now with the big move. don't know why he'd hold his arm position for someone to kick you like that, but... Ooh, elbow in the mouth. Ooh. You could hear the count from the ref. Can't be out already. Looks like Shawmownage is just taking his time. Resting for a bit. You know, Diablo's letting him. Oh, Max Handle takes him down. That catches him in the ropes pretty good. Grabbing a baseball bat now. Sorry about this, folks. Oh, now it's Shawmownage with the bat. Del Diablo's able to fight out of it. A reversal by Shawmownage. Big man's fighting back now. Oh, a big leg drop. Kicking the head now. Another stomp. Jump on the elbow. Slams him down. Flying crossbody by El Diablo and Shawmownage. I don't think headbutting the big man was the brightest idea. Now with the why did they throw that in here in the part of the game. There we Is that enough to keep the big man down? Oh, he's back on his feet. Oh, that's gotta hurt. What a DDT. Plants him. Oh no, the big man's going up. Oh! The move's destroyed so many of the people so far, and he's picking them up to give them more now. The tree of woe. Oh! Just a kick in the guts. I think after that mutilation, this might be over. As if the big splash wasn't enough, you had to put the icing on it. El Diablo coming on strong at the start. I don't know if the headbutt was the best idea. But if he's gonna drop the big splash and take somebody out, man. Surprised he even picked him up after that, just showing an even more aggressive side now. There you go, he wants that back. And it's all his. Shawmownage, your hardcore champion. So here we are, the second match of the night. Coming out first, we got a brand new tag team for y'all. This is the Assassins. Making their debut in KOW. Looks like the crowd seems pretty hyped up for these guys. Haven't heard too much about them. We'll have to see what. Crowd's cheering along, so maybe they know more about them than we do. And now, their masked opponents. Now I do remind you, these two gentlemen said they'd come over to KOW for a match, but they want to remain anonymous, so. Well, it's just that you didn't see anything there. Well, if you notice, we do a lot of ladders and TLCs and KOW. We figured it's a good way to run our tag matches, so it's just a climb to the top and get that contract that says that you won. Like I said, these two gentlemen asked us to keep them as anonymous and not mention their names and stuff, so they're not regulars on the KOW roster, but we're happy to have them here for the Assassin's debut. Try to keep up with you with what we can. Nice little reversal, and this time the kick lands. Oh, big reversal by Matt Hardy there. I mean, by that guy with the black and white hair. I'm gonna have to learn more about these assassins then, so. Just have to call them Black Ninja and White Ninja now first, I guess. That's what we roll with. Oh, huge! Jumps off, does a flip and squishes them. That was a nice one. Oh, Ramps him up for that little slam. Now he's climbing up the ladder. Does he have plans? Oh, backflip off the misses, and he's still standing there ready to go. Oh, slams him down on the stairs. He goes over to help his partner, it looks like. Big slam there. Spinning DDT. Drops the elbow. Is putting the boots of the Black Ninja over here. White Ninja and Jeff Hardy seem to be still scrapping along. Jeff looking for a weapon over there. Tosses him into the guardrail. Now he's throwing him back in the ring. Seen that move somewhere before. Now he's saying it's ladder time. That was a very interesting maneuver. Damage with the legs going through the ladder. Sit up, standing up powerbomb, whatever the hell they want to call that one. That was a big one. And now Max up climbing up the ladder. Just grabbing him off the ladder. Friends get a... Sorry, I'm a little speechless on that victory. It was looking like they were going for the easy win, try to wrap it up. Hope y'all enjoyed that. They beat the assassins, these mask guys. Episode 2, there was a pretty ferocious tag match where Seth Marshall here decided that he would help out his buddy Epic Justice and take on two members of Havoc, and they just got their asses kicked, if you want my opinion. So Seth Marshall saying that he wants another shot at Gary Reese, and he came to the ring with Mochachino, and now Mochachino's coming to the ring with him, so definitely think we're seeing the beginning of something here. Looks a lot more focused than the last couple times we saw him, so. Looks like Seth is ready to put down an ass kicking tonight. Dropped him on his head on the ladder and stuff. Gary Reese, he put the boots to him in episode 2, so. You can see him rubbing those knuckles. He's pumped up, man. But you have to be careful when these three are around. It's been pure dominance. No, we're only on our third episode. Basically, episode 1 and 2 is just Havoc taking over. Standing up front there, you have our KOW heavyweight champion. Behind him, Gary Reese, his alliance there. Can't even see her behind that beast of a man, but Erin Sokolov is there. She's in her main event tonight, taking on Marissa for the first women's heavyweight, women's championship here on KOW, so. But there they are. So far, those three have been ruling your KOW. None of them have seen a defeat yet on that team. Is Gary Reese going to be the first one to get a defeat? Stands here as Hank Thunder just owns the ring, eh? That's a scary man. Let's hope that he's ready for this one. Seth and Gary, there's that logo I was talking about that we saw in El Diablo's shirt, so. Kinda has me wondering. Fourth member of Havoc on the way? That could be even scarier. Now we gotta focus what we got going on in front of us. Oh, big kick in the head by Seth. Reversal by Gary Reese. Oh, Seth just gets up and kicks him in the head. Couple punches. Oh, shot in the mouth. He's fighting the boat storm now. Leg drop. He's living it up in there. Thank you. Well, talk from Seth saying he's just Gary's just been hiding behind the big man Hank, but and that kick works for him. Uppercut. Referee has a chair. What's he planning on doing with that? Guess that's one ref you don't want to be running into. Definitely make sure you stay legit in this one. Oh, ref just slides that chair out of the ring now. The slam by Gary. There we go, Gary showing some of his amateur wrestling skills. Whoa. Got Hank Sanger's attention, but I can't think staying out of it for now, which is surprising. Pulls him aside just to beat his ass a little bit. He goes talk to the big man, but the big man just throws him right back into the ring. Don't get distracted. Oh, big turnaround now by Gary Reese. Just slams him. That's trying to get to his feet, but Gary's got. Oh. Now the moves are coming. See? Why? Because he got distracted. Superman punch. Wow. Now he's going for the submission. We're fighting to get Garrett and get him out of this one. Oh. Not gonna lose over that distraction. Another reversal by Gary. Again with whatever that was. Reversal central here. What the face plant. Oh, he just booted. Oh, no, I almost slipped out there. He just booted him. He's busted open now. This is getting brutal. But the ref's still letting them go. Working that arm now. Heart. Oh, shoulder twist. Takes him down. He was just wearing him out now. Shows a good grip that Gary must have. Interesting. Is he gonna boot? If he does this, oh! Again, kicks him in the face. And the ref is letting this go. You can see the horrified look of Mochachino on the outside of the ring. Why won't... Seth is just crawling around the ring. Gary's picking him up. We got the reversal coming? Yes, we do. Seth showing he has fight left in him. Oh, throws him up and kicks him in the face. Nice move. Oh, big reversal again by Reese. Oh, that was a nice one. Flips him over and punches him in the head. Rolls him over. Oh, now he's going for the chokeout. No, there's no fighting this. Gary Reese showing that he's not just hiding behind the big man. Seth definitely trying to put up somewhat of a fight there, but boots him in the head twice and then strokes him out. Such a happy start to this match. Seth and Mochachino look like they had something good going. Okay, so as you know, our heavyweight champion, our hardcore champion is Shawmownage, and we're making a rule that the hardcore belt must be defended every episode. So we got a four-way KO war zone coming up for you. The winner of this is going to fight Shawmownage next week, so... We got Buddy Woodward. This match is a KO war zone, so that means it's, you get knocked out, you're done. But you're gonna knock out everybody to win, and there's four of them ready to go. First competitor here for you, Buddy Woodward. The one known as War. He's teamed up with the Butcher, but he seems to do better in the matches when he's by himself, so. See a dissolving of a tag team before it even begins, or maybe he'll just stand by the Butcher. Who knows if loyalty means anything to these guys or what. Doesn't even acknowledge Buddy. Staring down, see who's coming next. That's the way to do it! Evan Justice on his way to the ring. Looks like he's trying to turn around a little bit of a losing streak. Was in the title hunt, but looks like after some losses to Hank Thunder, he's turning his eyes to the Hardcore Championship. Was the champion, but he's just getting distracted, it seems. Looks like Kwan Satoru is pretty hooked up for an ass kicking here, so. Satoru came out, held his own in one of these four-way matches, but didn't quite make it to the finish line. Just wait, I'm getting some notes from the back that This is for the World Championship. The winner of this is facing Hank Thunder next week. Oh, well, that changes everything. Now we see why we got this level of competition in the ring. I might have made a mistake there because I think Kwan Satoru might have been the one who won that match last week. Definitely held his own in it anyway, so. Our apologies for that error here, man. We're bringing the great action, just working on the rest, so. Watching this one now to see who faces Hank Thunder next week. What a broadcast error there, our apologies. One-handed choke slam. Picks up the leg too, kind of thing, but. I don't know why he'd grab his ladder, but. We use a lot of ladders around here, so it's probably one of the first things that was accessible. So it took a little bit of time and got distracted though, and Buddy's getting a chance to go after him. Inside the ring, Kwan's laying some boots to the roar. High risk district. Flying, that was beautiful. Bloody Woodward just slammed him to the ground outside. See what I mean? We got so much action, we can't even keep up with it. Oh! Across the table. There's other guys down there just out broadcasting this in different languages, so that's why you don't hear them. Evan says, Buddy, meet chair. Kwan says, War meet ladder, but War moves out of the way. Smashes Kwan with the ladder. Everybody's kicking everybody's ass here tonight. What a crowd favorites we got here going out in this match. Which one of them is enough to take on Hank Thunder, though? And win. Big reversal there. That was a big one. Kwan Satoru just busted up more on the ladder there. Even wearing the mask, you can tell he's bleeding underneath it. Announcer's getting scared. Move there by Kwan Satoru. Definitely looks like he's the one that's been taking this match. Oh, till Buddy Woodward slams him across the ring. Oh, brutal move there, busts Kwan Satoru open now. Just anybody attack anybody. Kwan looks a little confused there for a second, but oh, he's going to be full. There's somebody's head bouncing off of a table over there. Third person busted open now. Huge DDT. Bigger power bomb, wow. And that's the end of Kwan. I thought Buddy was open, now he's just rampaging all over the place on everybody. The chair to the back brings an end to that rampage. way between the eyes with that one. Like reversing by war. Oh. Now it's war is turning a rampage. Oh, Satoru still just laid out. Getting himself some medical attention. Leg stomp there. Slams him back on the stairs. Knee to the face by war. Oh. Turns it to the face. Definitely seeing some like different maneuvers, like the backing away and everything else from Evan Justice. You can tell he really wants that title shot. Powerbomb. Guys, if this is for the world champion, we're still standing by the thing that we said earlier, that the hardcore championship must be defended each week. It looks like War's breaking up that move. Buddy grabs him now. Throws him into the turnbuckle. Oh, War's breaking that because he wants to be the one to kick his ass. Gives him the same move that Buddy did. Buddy rolled outside of the ring, but I don't think the ref called him as knocked out, so he is still actively in this match. The brutal slam there, this is insanity. Just finishes off Evan Justice. He got up quick, the bell rang, but you know Evan Justice is not going to be happy about that call. I don't even know if we're happy about that call. Oh, but that's enough to lay it out, and so next week, in the next episode, hopefully with better announcing and even crazier action, Buddy Woodward is going to be facing Hank Thunder for the KOW Championship. And you know Gary Reese won't be getting involved with that because he'll have AK-47 in his corner, his tag team partner from last week, so. Busted open, but ready for war. It looks like Hank Thunder. And look at that. And here we are. We're back. And this is our main event. We got Marissa Shatino. She won a six-woman ladder match last week. Last episode, last week. Whenever it happened. Who cares anymore, right? It's not then. She won her match. Talking about that positive attitude she always has coming to the ring, so always happy backstage. Hoping that positivity could bring her to her first ever women's championship here. Room goes dark and smoke fills the area. For the arrival of Havok. Hank Thunder. Haven't had a chance to talk to him yet about how he feels about facing Buddy Woodward next week. Could Buddy Woodward be the next KOW champion? Definitely showed a lot of heart in that match to get to it. And like we always say, Gary Reese is there with him. Seth Marshall was saying that Gary Reese was just hiding behind the big man, but Gary proved that wrong tonight in the big win. I see Erin Sokolov. She's definitely ready to go in this match. Add more gold to Havok. She wins tonight and becomes the first KOW Women's Champion. She's crazy and ready to go. The unstoppable force. Or does that change tonight? Is Marissa the first one to offer an upset? We borrowed an old school WWE belt there until we could get a chance to get our own belt. Hopefully we'll have that for you soon enough. Stomping her when she's down, just insulting. This one crazy move after another. Oh, missed something there. Still has time to recuperate. Walk. I need some offense from Marissa. Oh, one arm behind the back DDT. Goes for the kick, but Erin rolls out of it. Huge clothesline there. Knee drop. Why she's letting it get back up. Not getting up. Rolls over. It didn't quite go right for her there, but she is back up now. It'll take it a second to get her breath. Back to those stomps. Big drop. Misses. Starting this match looks like Erin Sokolov is totally taking control, but definitely back and forth right now. Getting more of the main event that we wanted out of this match now. Lots of hang time in that jump. That was nice. Pulls her up there. Oh, big reversal. Knees her in the head and she picks up her suplex. Try that one. Big miss there off the ropes. I was spinning her caramba there, done nicely. Well, it's there with the bulldog. Back in the corner. Big splash. Breaks right there. Big leg drop. She's wrapping her up for something. Let's go. Looks like she's still got fighting her. Kick to the kneecaps there, that had hurt. Big backbreaker. But again, she's looking to fly. Oh, drops the elbow right in the exact same position where those legs were dropping. Back up again. Another spot. It's just trying to crush her guts, it looks like. Nice DDT reversal there. Drop kicks her in the back. Oh, is she going for the reverse? Going for the submission. Aaron's not ready to go either. Kick to the knees takes her down again. Another splash. More kicks. Lance that DDT. In the back. Drops a knee on her face. Slam there now. Power bomb. It looks like she's getting ready for something. But Marissa says no way. Yeah, she's just totally surprising us with that spunk. Like with all that positive attitude comes a lot of hurt. Looks like it could be her getting ready to go for something big now. Oh, but it gets reversed by Erin Sokolov, and that dream comes to an end as she drops her on the back of her head. Big kick to the head now. Lippy spinny shit by Marissa. Spending too much time worrying about the crowd. Nice little maneuver there. Chucks around for a bit. I'd appreciate that move. Going back into the Boston Crab. Aaron saying, no way, bitch, you ain't getting my title that way. What a big slam there that was. There's a drop, brutal. Springboard monkey flip or something like that, they call that. No, some kind of monkey flip. Springboards when you bounce, yeah. I don't think we're winning any awards for announcements or for commentating anytime soon, but I'm a music DJ at heart, right? That's my place. That's right. Check it at AstroRabbit.ca. I'm mashing like a motherfucker trying to get through this. And again, she says, no way, bitch, you don't get my title. Already claiming ownership to it. shot in the back, followed by the backbreaker. Picks her up. And the bell starts ringing, they're calling it at that. I guess we're going to have to go with the ref's official call. Definitely been some officiating going, weird officiating going on lately here. A lot of weird officiating in the favor of Havok, if you know what I mean. Thanks for checking this out.